In part 3 of this lecture, we are going to look at a little bit about eukaryotic cells. Now, the first thing we need to know is that these are the examples of eukaryotic cells which we have studied in our previous chapters. Protists, plants, animals, fungi, all these have eukaryotic cells. And what did we see in eukaryotic cells? We already have seen this. There was extensive compartmentalization, meaning there were membrane-bound organelles. So whether it is the lysosomes, whether it is you had the chloroplasts, or you have the mitochondria, or you have the endoplasmic reticulum, these are all membrane-bound organelles and they are found in eukaryotic cells. We also saw a well-organized nucleus. We can call it as a well-defined nucleus, or we can call it as a nuclear membrane-bound nucleus. We have seen this, which was absent in the prokaryotic cells. Then locomotory structures are there if it is a motile cell, and you also have cytoskeletal structures which maintain the shape and the structure of the cell. Genetic material is inside the nucleus. It's in the form of chromosomes, and we know this, that chromosomes contain the DNA, RNA. So these are the few points about eukaryotic cell. And in the next lecture, we will be studying the details of each organelle. So this is just an introduction to eukaryotic cells. Now, the next is a question that I had already explained to you the differences. So this will be put up in classroom, and you will have to find out the differences between plant and animal cell. You will have to fill in the blanks. Okay, so students, for today I have pre-recorded these three parts of my lecture. Clear? And in case you can play these again and again till you understand, when we meet online next, you can ask me your doubts. Please ensure that all these questions up to question number 11, so from my first slide with question number 1 till question number 11, have to be noted on your notebook, and the answers have to be written. Thank you very much.